My name is Tushar. I work with organizations of tribals and forest dwelling communities in India, basically working on forest rights issues and also involved in the implementation of Forest Rights Act. I've been working for last 10 years, more than 10 years. And in the conference, in this land conference, Forest Rights Act has been discussed as a major issue. And we talked about implementation of Forest Rights Act in last 10 years. One of the major challenges has been that there is a general lack of understanding about the potential of this law. As a, this is a historic legislation, as most of us know. We have done some assessment of the Forest Rights Act potential in India, and what we have found out that Forest Rights Act, if it is fully implemented in India, it can benefit at least 200 million tribal and forest dwelling communities living in about 170,000 villages, and at least about 40 million hectares of forest land can be recognized and vested as community forest resources to the Gram Sabhas. So it is a huge potential that we see in the Forest Rights Act. We have also looked at the implementation of this law and the performance, and there we see it is very poor in last 10 years, and recognition of forest rights all across India is limited to just 3 to 5% of the overall potential, and especially so for the community forest resource rights. So in the conference, what we discussed and found out that there are very good numbers of initiatives by communities, local organizations working on Forest Rights Act, and they are engaged in the forest rights claim process. They are engaged in the community forest resource claims and mapping process, and there is very innovative use of technology for mapping resources, for management of resources and empowerment of Gram Sabhas. Now one of the thing as a way forward which is suggested by communities here is that the work which is done by a collective of organization and communities using technology, using innovative methods needs to be scaled up. So that is a major recommendation which is coming from this conference. At the same time, we are at this time, it's important because we are going for elections. The general elections are coming up, and it is important for us to tell the political parties about the importance of land and forest rights and what it means for livelihood security of communities. So we have also taken this opportunity to convey our ideas and the recommendations which have come up in the conference to political party representatives. And we have told them that the land and forest right issues need to be the priority for political parties in their manifesto and later on in the government program.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.